Townsville turns 150, the old and the news, represents Townsville's history since 1866, and also gives visitors an insight into the major role the media has played.
Thank you very much.
We have a very significant number of very important guests this afternoon. I'd just like to acknowledge the Member for Townsville, Mr. Scott Stewart, MP, Representative of the Bindal Traditional Owners Group, Jeanette Wiles, and Mr. Reinhard Geminder, the Mayor of Townsville, Jenny Hill, the Senator Ian MacDonald, Senator for Queensland, James Cook University Vice-Chancellor and President, Professor Sandra Harding. This area of the country has extraordinary longer history to pull upon, and so I am very delighted now to welcome Mrs. Jeanette Wiles, as I said, representing the Bindal Traditional Owner Group, accompanied by Reinhard Geminder on the didgeridoo, to give us a welcome to country.
The Birragubba people are the people from Townsville down to the Whitsundays, and part of the Birragubba nation are the Bindal people, traditional owners of the land on which we stand today. Thank you once again to the museum for welcoming us along and having part of a protocol with the Welcome to Country. And when you do go through your exhibition, there are two panels in reference to the Bindal people and the Walkaroopaba people. I wish you all the best today, Watanooli, and welcome to the future.
I'm really delighted now to introduce to you Mr. Scott Stewart, Member for Townsville, to say a few words.
It's always a real pleasure to experience the opening of a new exhibition, especially when it's one that celebrates our own region and its histories. The exhibition is one of many events, activities and displays taking part in Townsville in 2016 to celebrate the city's 150th anniversary.
I'm the Vice-Chancellor and President of James Cook University. Sandra Harding was appointed to that position in 2007.
Ladies and gentlemen, I am absolutely delighted to join you this afternoon for Townsville Turns 150, the old and the news. In my role as Vice-Chancellor, but also as a sociologist who's deeply interested in social and economic history. Our university has grown remarkably since being proclaimed as a university in 1970 by Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II, and you'll see that in the exhibition too. When I did view the exhibition earlier, it gave me great pleasure to see the illustrations by the late satirical cartoonist Robert Hebden, or Heb, as he was affectionately known, who worked for the Sun newspaper. The James Cook University Hebden Encouragement Bursary will be awarded for the first time in Semester 1 this year to a third-year arts education student studying primary education. I'm certain that the awardees will find that the bursary will open doors to professional and personal growth that can be only of benefit to their careers as they develop. In conclusion, I commend all those involved. And preserving that collective memory of our community through a major collaboration, as evidenced in this exhibition, provides an important platform for Townsville's vibrant future. Again, my very best congratulations to all involved in realising an outstanding reflection of Townsville in this, our birthday year. Thank you.
150 years ago, Townsville held its first council meeting to have the town crier, and yes, we did have a town crier, read out the proclamation of this city. And can I say, do any of you know where the first council meeting was held? The Criterion Hotel. Now, how apt is that for a council meeting? I wish we could do that today. As mayor, I am extremely proud of Townsville's achievements over the last 150 years and the city's status as a progressive Northern Capital and a centre for education, research, commerce, administration, industry, training and employment. Townsville has a rich and varied history that today we are paying tribute to. Townsville turns 150, the old and the news, represents a fantastic collaboration between James Cook University, our city libraries, the Museum of Tropical Queensland, local TV producer Pat Lyons, and of course the Townsville Bulletin.
Ladies and gentlemen, I would just now like to finish up by saying that we do have a huge thank you to say to all the staff, the volunteers, the students who worked on this project. But please also stay and enjoy the hospitality of the Museum of Tropical Queensland. Thank you very much.
Thank you.